The convicted Lake Mary real estate swindler who claims he's just too obese to be treated in prison has changed his tune.
By 2 p.m. today, 48-year-old James Olivos had been ordered to turn over all documentation of several physical ailments that repeatedly delayed his reporting to prison. Olivos was supposed to begin a 5-year term months ago.
WESH's Bob Keeling joining us live right now with his exclusive investigation. And Bob, this guy avoided that deadline today by asking for more time again.
Yeah, that's right, Martha. He filed an emergency request yesterday, deciding after all, according to this paperwork, that he would turn himself in despite having all of these physical problems. The judge granted it, but now the question is, will he follow through? Do you still contend you're too morbidly obese to...
Yes, I am, sir. Thank you very much.
To avoid another appearance today before the magistrate who Tuesday accused him of stalling to avoid serving his 5-year prison sentence for mortgage fraud, 48-year-old James Olivos instead filed this emergency motion yesterday. While he still claims to have, quoting now, a plethora of medical problems, including obesity, in his 4th request for more time, Olivos requested 48 hours to self-surrender to begin his sentence. That request was granted.
As far as the courts are concerned, this is the end of the road for him.
Legal analyst Richard Hornsby says it's hard not to be skeptical of Olivos' request to turn himself in after coming up with excuse after excuse not to do so since his December sentencing.
Whether or not he'll change his mind, no one knows, but he doesn't seem to be somebody that wants to go to jail voluntarily.
The truth will be told.
Olivos now has a Friday 2 p.m. deadline to turn himself in to this medium security prison in Edgefield, South Carolina. In addition to his 5-year prison term, Olivos has been ordered to pay $2.86 million, which the feds say was the amount of money he made off of real estate scams in Seminole County from 2003 to 2007. Now, we did some checking, and so far, Olivos is not listed as being incarcerated at that prison up in South Carolina. Meanwhile, the clock is ticking. The deadline is tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock, and if he doesn't meet it, Hornsby says very likely new criminal charges will follow. And, of course, we'll follow it, too. Reporting live from the federal courthouse in Orlando, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.